Hey, and welcome to my channel. So the special site for patch 5.4 has been released in both the Japanese and the English versions, and I wanted to go over everything that we can actually see in here. If you're looking for a summary of the patch 5.4 live letter information that we got about a month ago, which is going to cover a lot of the stuff that we are seeing now in the special site, I would suggest that you head over to my video and check that out. And as always, if this content helps you out and you want to help support my channel, I'd super appreciate if you lobbed a ton of patch notes, like a stack of them, onto that like button and cat daddied that subscribe button. The patch has been officially named Futures Rewritten and is coming early December 2020, although the official date has not been officially posted. We are currently speculating that it is going to be around December 8th. Likewise, the art in the background is of Rin and Gaia, who are major characters, especially in the story of the raid, which I know that not everyone has played through all of the raid content, but if you haven't yet, I really strongly suggest that you do. One thing about this art is that I really want to show the Twitter picture, because the website image doesn't really show it quite as clearly, but you can see it. The red-masked Ascian, robed in white, no spoilerinos here, is in the background there. And so that definitely is something that I'm noticing that a lot of people are missing, because the hand-holding is a great, absolutely, but let's not lose sight of the bigger picture going on here. As with all mainstay patches, we are going to be getting a brand new set of main scenario quest lines underlying Futures Rewritten, where we're having Futures Rewritten, Futures Unknown. With Elidibus defeated and the fate of the first secured, the Scions make their long-awaited return to the Source. But in the new future they now look towards, will that which is written upon the pages of history be an anthem of hope or a dirge of despair? Likewise, from the first image, we can see that Alphinoa and Alice are in Limsa Lominsa, just going off of background image there, and then we have it that Alphinoa is seeming to console Alice, maybe because she's in physical trauma, maybe because she's having issues with coming back from the first. And then in the second image, we can see that we're in Ishgard and that we're being approached by Sir Emeric and Lucia with a Vanu Vanu seeming emissary, I'm gonna guess, in the background. And so there's likely gonna be a lot of things pointing back to the Heavensward expansion, which makes me very excited. As for patch 5.4 special content, we know that there was going to be a new raid tier introduced, which goes with every even-numbered patch, and this one is going to be called Eden's Promise. And so we can see here in the image that we are seeing Gaia there holding a particular white crystal, and so the description is, Rin and her mysterious counterpart Gaia have succeeded in restoring balance to the elements of the empty. Much of the credit goes to the Warrior of Light, whom they invite to observe whether life continues to flourish in the once barren desert. While the flame of hope burns ever brighter than ever, this tale is far from over. The next piece of content is called Matoya's Relict, which is given the description of the Maker's Quarter was once home to some of the finest crafters Eorzea had ever seen, but it has lain in forgotten ruin since the Charlian Exodus. It is there, hidden amongst overgrown foliage, and the entrance to the former workshop of the Archon Meitoya can be found. Likewise, looking at the images, we can see something that is resembling a Charlian library in here, and then we have this giant metal, almost witch's hat kind of looking elevator apparatus, which I'm not 100% sure what it could be. It could be like a submersible submarine, it could be an elevator, I'm not 100% sure what it is, but it is definitely catching my interest for sure. As for the second image, we can see what is likely one of the mini boss fights, which seems to be some animated water sprite that honestly looks really cute with those eyes, and I'm really hoping that this drops a minion. Is that optimistic thinking? I don't know, but I think that would be a super cute minion to have. The third content drop is going to be Chronicles of a New Era, The Sorrow of Wurlit. Gaius and the Warrior of Light are a step closer to thwarting the Empire's War Machina development project after vanquishing the Sapphire Weapon. However, newly unearthed information alludes to another foe lurking in the shadows, and you must take decisive action before it is too late. As for the image associated with this content, we can see two of the main characters from this Chronicles of a New Era for the Shadowbringers expansion here, and so likewise we have already been told, as for the live letter notes that were given earlier, that this is going to be associated with the Emerald Weapon Trial. Likewise, at the end of the website we get a little bit of a summary of everything that we're going to see in patch 5.4, which includes main scenario quests, Eden's Promise raids, the new dungeon, the Chronicles of a New Era, all of the stuff that we just went over, but we're also seeing a new trial of Castrum Marinarum. And likewise, with that, we're gonna see the addition to the Shadowbringer's Relic Weapon, which is Save the Queen, cast to rest, then a new large-scale battle called Delubrium Reginae, which likewise one of these fights is going to be coming in a harder savage mode, which is suggested information that we were told from our last live letter. Likewise, we're going to have a Blue Mage update, which we know is going to boost the Blue Mage up to level 70, and likewise add a ton of new spells, and opening the floodgates to Blue Mages being able to tackle Stormblood content, which is very exciting because level 70 to our current level 80 cap is actually getting very relevant very quickly, which is super exciting. Next up, we're going to get Ishgardian Restoration updates, which is going to bring forth a lot more opportunities for people to achieve new titles and achievements that they may not have been able to get in the past. After that, we're going to also be talking about a new Unreal Trial, which has not currently been announced what it's going to be, but we just had Shiva as our Unreal Trial, and likewise, they're probably, in my opinion, looking at maybe Ifrit, maybe Titan, but that might be a little too obvious, so they might be doing something that's going to throw out of completely left field. Next up, we're going to get Skysteel Tool updates, likewise, that makes sense because we have this Guardian Restoration update, and Ocean Fishing updates. We have updates also to minigames including Triple Triad, Dome and Mahjong, and then we have the brand new Explorer mode which is being added to the game, as well as there's going to be performance updates, which when we're talking about performance updates in this instance, we're not talking about like game performance updates because I'm pretty sure that they do them in the background all the time, although they don't really announce them, but when we're talking about performance here, we're talking about like Bard and like music performance updates. And then we're going to be talking about a new Game Plus updates, which I'm hoping might help people do different things with it, because I know a lot of players have gone into New Game Plus and have tried it out and really love the system, and I'd love to see it fleshed out from here. Anyhow, that does it for the special site, and I am going to actually be plugging a few patch 5.4 videos here. I've covered all of my personal patch 5.4 prep tips and tricks in this video over here, which is Preparation is Hot and Always Good to Do. And then I want to also plug the Live Letter 5.4 information that we got about a month ago about what we're going to expect in patch 5.4, so it might give you a little bit more detail on what we are covering in this special site video. Likewise, new patch information is going to come out with another live letter that's coming up soon, and if you want to hear about that from my channel, I'd super appreciate if you can't daddy that subscribe button, and if you threw a stack of live letter patch notes at that like button. Don't worry, the like button likes that. Anyhow, all jokes aside, I super honestly hope that you are as hyped for patch 5.4 as I am, and that you honestly are taking care, and just, during this crazy year, you know what, there's been so much going on, seriously take care, and I hope that I'm gonna catch you in my next video.